Hello, my name is Dr. Darkley, and it's my pleasure to welcome Dr. Jean-Claude Dumoroy de Courrier de Castelnau, who is an expert in non-surgical treatment of scoliosis. Dr. Dumoroy is the past president of the European Spine Center at the Clinique du Parc in Lyon. He's the past president of the International Society of Spine Research and past president of SOSORT in 2013. He is the inventor of the scoliosis art brace and teaches and trains physiotherapists in the Lyon method of physiotherapy scoliosis specific exercises. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, Derek.
All right.
It's a pleasure to be with you.
Now, today we're going to focus on the Lyon method of physiotherapy for scoliosis. And you have a presentation for us, I believe.
Mm-hmm. Yes. I will share the screen. The first aspect is the most effective parameters of the Lyon method. The Lyon method is built on two systems, the stimulation of the postural system and the mechanical correction of scoliosis. The mechanical correction of scoliosis. Why the postural system? Because the beginning of the Lyon method is 200 years ago, after an experimentation from a French physiologist, Jean-Pierre Flourens, who describe the scoliosis of the pigeon after destruction, vestibular destruction of the labyrinth. He aspected deafness, but it was a scoliosis for this pigeon. And now we know better the delay of maturation of the postural system. We have many publications, experimental study with perturbation of the postural system with scoliosis, idiopathic scoliosis. And the maturation of the postural system is 12 years, both for boys and girls. So this explains that we have more scoliosis with girls because the beginning of the puberty is at 11 years. We have only 20% of boys because they begin the growth, pubertal growth, at 13 years. This concept was explained very well by Burwell, and this is notum, the concept of notum. So we have to stimulate this postural system to compensate this delay of maturation. But not only. The deviation of the spine creates a very imbalance of the postural system. And we can make a mechanical correction. All PSSE methods are working on this mechanical correction. Perhaps the Lyon method is a little different. We have the plastic deformation. This is a characteristic of the Lyon method with before the plaster cast and now the full-time bracing. We have the 3D correction particular by coupled movements. Coupled movements, we correct the sagittal plane, the frontal plane, and automatically we will have a motion in the horizontal plane. It's not exactly the same correction with the Schrott on other methods. We have also the concept of tensegrity and the concept of solid geometry. We will see some more explanation of this. So the postural balance, postural system, we know perfectly the vision, vestibular system, the proprioception, the importance of the foot, but we know the integration, but we know a little less the static and dynamic problem. In fact, there is no static posture. In permanence, we have mobility around the gravity line. This mobility with integrated circuits at the brain level between feedback with reactive postural response and anticipatory postural adjustment, feed forward, we can say. We have an oscillation between this feed forward and feed. This is important to make a good physiotherapy on the postural system. The static position in reality non-exist. Alors, this is to simplify so we understand better. At 1 year, we have the stabilization and the control of the pelvis. So it's not very, we can not do a lot at for newborn scoliosis, we can say, newborn scoliosis. But between 1 year and 6 years, when the patient is walking, we can work on the reticulospinal tract because we have an ascending modification of the posture. For instance, we can walk along a line. It's perfect for stimulating the reticulospinal system. At 7 years, we have a stabilization of the head. And at this time, between 7, 8 years, we have a descending maturation of the postural system. This is the vestibulospinal system, tractus. And we can begin all exercise with a tilting tray because we work on this vestibulospinal tract of the postural extrapyramidal system. 9 years, we have the vision, the better vision, and we work at this time with the tectospinal tract. This is tectospinal tract for the postural system is the mirror. The Schrott was using also the mirror. And at 9 years, it's perfect. The exercise is with a little sand sack on the head and on tip two, walking on the tip two before the mirror. So we work on this tectospinal system. Between 9 and 12, 13 years, we have the maturation of the postural system, and we can work on the rubrospinal system with the Swiss ball, the Klein-Fogelbach, the Swiss ball to have more imbalance on the postural system. And between 13 years and adult, we have the problem of the bone mass, and to increase the fixation of the calcium on the spine, it's the axial impact. So it's perfect with walking, running at this time to increase the resistance of the vertebral body. I continue, but between at adult time, it's a decline of the postural system. We have some important point. At 40 years, between 20, 21 and 40, no problem. All is working very well. At 14 years, between the sarcopenia, diminution at the muscular level. And at this time, it's important to work on this strengthening of the core muscles, all muscles of the postural system, the deep muscles, to reinforce, to compensate this sarcopenia due to scoliosis. Before 40 years, there is no problem with strengthening, muscular strengthening. Between 40 and 55, we begin to have a diminution of visual and vestibular signals. And at this time, it's important to use, this is the stick of the Lion method with a level stick, to stimulate the vision and the vestibular system, semicircular canals. We must work on this. At between 55 and 75, we have the problem. We insist on the cognitive approach. This is a double task. This means to make the exercise, the same exercise, but asking the patient to count, for instance, from 100 to 90, 100, 99, 98, during the exercise. The double task is very important to increase this cognitive approach. And at the end, we have the degeneration of the extrapyramidal system. This is the comptocornea or the PISA syndrome in the frontal plane. Alors, to understand the 3D bicoupled movements, it's very easy. This is a very simple biomechanical model. We create an asymmetric tension between concavity and convexity. And when we are going in declive position, this is like at the thoracic level, we have the rotation in one way, and like the lumbar level, we have the rotation in the other way. It's only a little asymmetry of tension between concavity and convexity to give, due to the kyphosis and lordosis, this cuneiformization of vertically, we will have a rotation. This is important to understand why the layer, how the Lion method is working. So for us, it's very important the sagittal plane. We begin to correct the sagittal plane, and all begin with pelvic incidence. Pelvic incidence is a constitutional factor, and we have a correlation to have a good isostatic balance between the pelvic incidence, 33, between the pelvic tilt, lordosis, and kyphosis. So with only an X-ray in the sagittal plane at the beginning, we can calculate if the patient is well balanced in the sagittal plane, isostatic balance, or if we must correct something. And this is the first correction in the sagittal plane, both for physiotherapy and bracing, because if you have the sagittal plane in good isostatic balance, you will maximum mobility in the frontal plane. So we correct the sagittal plane. We can see making the brace for the molding for the brace. So we have three scans. The first is in geometric detorsion, auto elongation. Very easy. We control both sagittal and frontal plane. And you see we have a good lordosis in the sagittal plane, but not very, it's missing a little kyphosis. The second cast scan is done in lordosis and lumbar shift. It's not exactly the shift of mean meta, it's a little different. And this is the third cast for the thoracic, third mold for the thoracic region. we make elasticization and correction in the frontal plane, bending in the frontal plane. Why this difference between the lumbar region and the thoracic region? This is due to the orientation of the articular facets. In the frontal plane, the facets are in the thoracic region. Sorry, the facets are in the frontal plane. So it works in bending. In the sagittal plane, the facets are in the lumbar region. The facets are in the sagittal plane. So it's impossible. Bending it's not possible. It's only possible with a translation, a frontal translation. This is to have the maximum of mechanical correction. And we can see the least effective of the method, but I think not only the Lyon method, all physiotherapy method. The main problem is that orthopedic medicine is not a medical specialty. We have few medical doctors before to make the plaster cast. We have surgeons, it's okay. But non-surgical treatment is a little different. It's really a specialty. And we have in France, we were perhaps three or four medical doctors practicing with practice of orthopedic medicine. The second problem of this treatment is longer treatment time than surgery. Surgery is very, in 15 days, we resolve the problem. With non-surgical treatment, it needs minimum 2 years of treatment, physiotherapy, and sometimes bracing. And another problem is that we don't have a visual effect of surgery, but the brace is not very aesthetic, so we have some problem. But we can say that this is all the treatment with the hard brace. This is adolescent scoliosis, adult scoliosis, and what is interesting is the dropout. We have only 10% of dropout. In the literature, usually the weight, the percentage is 20%. This means that 10% of our patients don't make, there is an interruption of treatment, sometimes at the beginning, sometimes during treatment. They don't go till the weaning of the brace. This is the inconvenient, we can say, but all non-surgical treatment, it's the same. Missing of some specialists and the duration of the treatment. The result of this treatment, the validation of the Lyon method was done 30 years ago. Publication in French literature, so we don't appear in the English publication, I think. It was very simple. When I see the patient, we choose the patient between 10 years and 15, 16 years. We follow this patient. When the general practitioner has prescribed physiotherapy, we continue physiotherapy. So this is the group of physiotherapy. You know that randomization is very difficult for the patient to accept randomization for the patient. So this is quite a randomization. It was only if the general practitioner prescribes the physiotherapy or don't prescribe physiotherapy. So It's the weight and see the observation. And between 10 and 16 years, we have 210 patients. And this is the group without physiotherapy, beginning at 13 degrees, more or less, at the end at 20, 23 degrees at the end. With physiotherapy beginning at 16, 17 degrees, and a little progression, less than without physiotherapy. This was a validation of the Lyon method. It's not the same for other methods, but I think it's the best system if we will avoid real randomization. This was my first slide presentation. If you have some more questions, Derek, I can respond.
Absolutely. So for adolescent idiopathic scoliosis, what were the best parameters for the Lyon method in terms of the age, Cobb angle, in terms of the success rate, and the ability to, because most braces these days, the idea is to try and stop progression, right? Mm-hmm. And that's would be success. So what are the starting points for using the Lyon method in terms of idiopathic scoliosis? Right.
So we have a concept, original concept. We think that under 25 degrees, between 20 and 25 degrees, the postural system is working in a chaotic way. You know that the postural system, we have the maturation, and we have the connection with the environment, the epigenetic. It's the same. We have genetic and epigenetic. So for us, under 25 degrees, we don't begin with a Jan Stokes vicious circle. We are in a chaotic phase. Mm-hmm. So the Lyon method responds perfectly because it's stimulating the postural system. So you have seen with the validation, we begin at 15 degrees, we can say between 15 and 25 degrees. After 20 degrees, if you have a progression, or 25 degrees, if you see the first time the patient, we have this vicious circle and we have a linear progression. And at this time, it's necessary to use the brace. We complete the mechanical correction with the brace for many reasons. It depends the age of the patient. You know that at 11 years, with a night brace, you can have a relaxation of the intervertebral disc, the nucleus of the intervertebral disc. Mm-hmm. With scoliosis, the nucleus is toward convexity. And with a night corrective brace, we have a realignment of the nucleus of the intervertebral disc. This is very important. During the day, we have other effects. So the ideal for us is to begin the treatment at the good time, really at the beginning of this vicious circle. And so we can have sometimes very good correction with, at the end of treatment, under 10 degrees. It's not it's not the usual case, almost for us. Most of the time we begin after 30 degrees, and at this time we have some rigidity, some stiffness of the spine due to this translation of the nucleus of the intervertebral disc and the deformation of the vertebral body. So it's very important to begin with, we can say, with urgency, not to wait 6 months for build the brace, because I see some patient 20 degrees in June and at 11 years, 20 degrees June, and we say, okay, the summer holidays, we expect September 40 degrees. So in 2-3 months, we can have a progression from 20 to 40 degrees. So the idea is to have the maximum possible correction with the quality of the cartilage growth, the gross cartilage, the possibility of the cartilage growth. And after, there is also another problem. The response, this curve was made with the braced study. If you wear the brace 2023 or 2024, you have 100% of maximal correction. But due to the hyperbolic aspect of this curve, if you wear the brace 16 hours every day, so you have 8 hours without brace, you have 95% of the maximum possibility of correction. So it's another problem. Begin at the beginning with a brace, minimal angulation, and adapt the protocol between compliance, possibility of compliance, and what we want to obtain. It's better to lose 3-4 degrees and maintain the brace till the end of treatment than search the maximal correction and to lose the patient. So it's a very difficult for us. The work is very difficult. We must always have a balance, a compromise of what we do.
Absolutely. But with the lion method, I believe that was the first method with respect to physiotherapy, scoliosis, specific exercises that looked at sagittal alignment first. Is that correct?
Yes, it's true. I was co-author of the first publication, 1982, of morphotypology of the sagittal plane. Because before, we make only X-ray in the frontal plane. And we begin 40 years, more or less 40, 50 years to work in the sagittal plane. With some difficulty, because at this time there was not the same quality of the X-ray, it was difficult to measure. Mm. But we published in Spine the first morphotypology of the sagittal plane with patients between 20 and 30 years. Because before, we don't know exactly the limit of hyperkyphosis and hyperlordosis. We don't know nothing about pelvic incidence. It was Duval Beaupère, a colleague in France, who worked on the pelvic incidence and the correlation, this correlation, the sagittal isostatic balance. Yes, we work a lot on this because in the Lion method, we need the sagittal plane to make the 3D correction.
I think all methods need the sagittal plane.
Alors, today, all methods are effectively working also on the sagittal plane. It's true. But the 3D correction is not always made with coupled movements. Many methods are working also directly in the horizontal plane. we with the Lion method is not a big point. This is not a big point. We work only in the sagittal and the frontal plane.
I guess the question that I'm really interested in, I'm familiar with Schroth and Sees in terms of the exercises they prescribe. Will you be able to show us some examples of
Yes,
the
yes,
Lion
yes, yes.
methodology?
I have some. Okay. So as you say, the Lion method is the oldest method. First publication was 1827, I think, after this publication of the vertebral of the destruction, labyrinthic destruction. And you see in this book, the book you can have it on internet. It's French, it's in French, but you have some pictures, and these pictures is a very good synthesis of what was done at this time, the beginning of the Lion method. We have exactly the mechanical correction of the curve, like the Schroth posture. We have it's exactly the same. So the Schroth is 1924, 100 years after. And it was another aim. It was to avoid bracing. Katerina Schroth has a scoliosis, and she had a brace. Brace at this time were not so good than today, and she worked a lot on bracing because at this time, poliomyelitic scoliosis were more frequent than idiopathic scoliosis. So she works a lot on bracing, but the mechanical correction was the same. And what is the originality of the Lion method is the orthopedic sway, the balançoire orthopedic in French, the orthopedic sway to both correct the deviation and to stimulate the postural system. This was a sort of reprogramming of the postural system in a corrected position. The brace don't exist at this time. The brace is more recent, I think, 100 years ago. But they have some other systems, very very easy to correct. Pravaz was both engineer and orthopedic surgeon. So it was possible to build some mechanical device to maintain the position, the corrected position during the day and also during the night. Alors, the other method was derived from the Schroth, more or less. There are two schools of Schroth, and also some association of Schroth and Clapp, and Fitz, it's a little different. The CEAS is, we can say, an evolution of the Lion method, because I work also in Italy, so I know very well the colleagues who are conceptualizing the CEAS. And it's a very interesting evolution because they complete the stimulation of the postural system with a connective aspect. We have seen before, we have the double task for instance, is the Lion method, but it's possible to have a better cognitive approach also for adolescent patients and adult patient. And this is an evolution of the Lyon method. It's not totally different. Alors, another difference is the classification. With the Lyon method, we remain very simple, like Ponseti classification 50 years ago. We don't change. We have a double curve and one curve. One curve and a double curve. And both physiotherapy and bracing are based. We don't need a complex classification. You see, for Schrott, this first publication classification, seven types of scoliosis, nine types of scoliosis, 12 types of scoliosis. We don't need this classification to build the brace, because the brace is made directly on the patient. And with the progress of the software, we are able to have a segmental regional approach, lumbar and thoracic, and to rebuild started scoliosis at the contrary, for the contrary, contrary deviation with the software. The other difference is the plastic deformation, very important for the Lyon method, before with the plaster. The correction, this is a Schrott publication, was done exactly the same. You see the geometric torsion, the auto elongation here, and the three-point correction in the frontal plane. But a little difference is that the patient is in total lordosis, and the correction was only during 20 minutes, 30 minutes. So we are always in the elastic region, like physiotherapy. The correction during the physiotherapy exercise is only elastic deviation. If we want a plastic deformation, this is a lengthening, real lengthening of the concavity, to obtain this squeep, we must maintain the brace or the plaster cast, like the plaster cast, full time, minimum 3 or 4 weeks, minimum 1 month. Like we can say the foot, when we have a club foot with the Ponseti correction of the club foot, every 3 weeks, the plaster, the cast was changing to correct progressively, to modify, to have this plastic deformation. It's exactly the same for the spine. The other difference with the other methods, you see the Schrott, for instance, is working with blocks. We have the blocks. But we have also, I say, the lumbar region, the thoracic region, but we work in solid geometry, because the scoliosis, it's helicoidal deformation, is this helicoid with axial, we can say horizontal translation of the apical vertebrae. So we don't speak of rotation, really rotation, we speak of torsion, detorsion. To obtain a good detorsion, we have a high rigidity piece at the upper part, at the shoulder, and the same high rigidity piece at the pelvis. The pelvis and the shoulder are fixed points. And we make the mechanical detorsion only at the thoracic and the lumbar level. If we have one thoracolumbar curve, it's like this. If we have two curves, we need do exactly the same, and we have also a rigid part of the spine at the thoracolumbar region. This is possible because at the musculature level, we have a crossing of the extension muscles at the thoracolumbar level. So the fixed point is with the hard brace and the old lion brace, it was the same, at the thoracolumbar region. So it's the concept is a little different. We speak with rigid blocks and deformable blocks at the thoracic and lumbar region. We need also to, with the geometrical distortion, the lengthening along the vertical axis, we need also an effect in the horizontal plane to maintain the apical vertebra on the gravity line. This is important to work both to realize geometrical distortion and mechanical distortion. So Milwaukee brace was working only in geometrical distortion. It was not too bad. It was a good system with a pad. It was possible to have a little translation. So it was a good brace. But with the underarm braces, there is sometimes with the Cheneau brace no stabilization of the pelvis. The pelvis is like a vertebra, it's not a stable point. And the same for the shoulder. There is no stabilization of the shoulder. This is the difference between the Cheneau and the hard brace. You see, all methods are working a little differently with the same objective, the same aim. But more or less, I think the Schrott, the original Schrott, was done for poliomyelitis scoliosis, very important curve of poliomyelitis scoliosis with the orientated bracing towards the concavity. It's not the same today with idiopathic scoliosis. So I am very happy to see that my colleagues who are making using the Schrott are progressively integrating this postural system in their physiotherapy. So there is a convergence, I think, of PSSC today. But if we think of the original method, it's also useful because so we understand better how we can work today. For some patients, it's important. Sometimes it's not possible to make a brace in good condition, and the Schrott work a lot on this mechanical correction without brace, so it's possible to use, and you have seen we don't have a great difference on the mechanical correction with the Lion method and the Schrott and other methods.
Absolutely, it's pretty fascinating, the history. I didn't realize the Lion method was 100 years predating Katarina Schroth.
But alors, perhaps the Lion method was a publication, but it was the same for Europe, because 1820, it was Napoleon. Napoleon would make a sort of unification. And you know that the exercises, there was no physiotherapy at this time, there was exercise, was deriving from the Kung Fu, the Chinese Kung Fu.
Really?
Because there was a priest, Father Amyo, if I remember, a Jesuit priest, who was at the, with in China, and he bring the exercise of the Kung Fu in France, and all the gymnastics, Swedish gymnastic, Kalinistic, I don't know exactly, Swedish gymnastic of Ling. At this time, the king of Sweden was a Marechal of Napoleon. So there
Okay.
was a direct connection between France and Sweden. And all the exercise was derived from, at the beginning, the Kung Fu and the Ling gymnastic, Swedish gymnastic of Ling. It was an adaptation. So we have a world.
It's amazing.
World history, but I can present the results, the long-term results. It's interesting because, as I say, in France, 50, 40 years ago, there was exactly the same physiotherapy for all France and only the Lion method. It was a method used in France, and the plaster cast was done in Paris, in all the city of France. So it was possible to have the very long time results 20 years and 40 years after the winning of the boys. The inclusion criteria was the plaster cast. But many patients at this time have this protocol. And there was two surgeons in Lyon who were doing this, and exactly the same protocol. So it's interesting. And the first, I don't know, this is, oui, another problem is SRS criteria. SRS criteria are recent, you know, patient between 10 years and under research 2, angulation between 2025, etc. And there was a recent publication of the results after the winning of the boys. And I want to show you from the result of the hard brace, the statistic. You have here the initial angulation for in red lumbar curve and in blue thoracic curve. And you see the winning at 15, 16 years, more or less, and winning at 6 months. So there is a very stabilization, and winning at 2 years after 2 years after winning. So we don't have this progression of the curve at the winning of the boys that was in this English publication. This is the SRS criteria patient and the whole statistic, quite 300 patients with a long curve. And this is, it's also the same for us. And this difference is probably due to the progressive winning of the brace and the plastic deformation at the beginning. So we have a very good initial stability with the winning of the brace. Alors, this is the long-term results. So we have more than 100 patients who are seen, 105 patients, 60, because we need the initial X-ray. This is a big problem. We have a lot of patients, but they lose the initial X-ray. So we don't have the initial point. So for 100 patients, I think it's very significant. The initial angulation was 35 degrees. under at the winning of the treatment, the end of treatment, the angulation was 25. And you see a very good stability, winning more 5 years after winning, 10 years after winning, 15 years after winning, 20 years after winning. And sorry, the initial correction was 20 years after winning, we have 5 degrees of less than the initial angulation. We lose effectively some degrees between the winning of the brace and 20 years after, but only 5 degrees. And we see that between 20 and 30 years, we have a little more progression. I think it's probably due to menopause, hormonal problems. I don't know exactly. In 10 years, we lose 3 degrees, 5 degrees, 6 degrees more between 20 and 30 years. But we are very happy with this very long time results, because the English publication show that there is not a big difference between natural history and evolution of scoliosis after winning the brace. Alors, we calculate, because we have many publications with natural history, especially from Ponseti publication, and we measure with a graphical reproduction evolution on the publication, we measure the beginning 36 degrees and 20 years for 35 degrees, more or less. The progression publication, also French publication, is half a degree every year. And we calculate our progression for, at the beginning, 35 degrees, we have only 0.17 degrees every year. As I say, a little more between 20 and 30 years. So there is a difference, not only during the growth period, but also bracing is changing the natural history in adult life, minimum 20 years. This is the time of for the children. So it's very important, I think, for the patient. So we have a difference between English publication and our experience. I present this graphic, this evolution at San Francisco before the COVID. The COVID created a big perturbation, and for the moment, I have not published this result, but I think it could be interesting to publish them, because the difference is the plastic deformation, the total time at the beginning. And it's not bad, this total time at the beginning. Perhaps more easy in France, because the patient knows that there was necessary to make a plaster cast, and they are happy to avoid the plaster cast with the hard brace, and they accept the total time. But not only. If you use the total time, you create an anesthesia, like the watch. You create a local anesthesia. So it's better to adapt for adaptation. And I see some very good, I have patients who are asking, sending me their X-ray under Cheneau brace with 50% of in-brace correction. So it's possible at this level of in-brace correction to make total time at the beginning. It's not difficult. And they will have exactly the same results. It's also possible for a Cheneau brace to have a very good embrace correction. It depends, I think, more of the orthotist. The advantage of the hard brace is that we have a very precise protocol and the correction directly on the patient. So it's easier to have an uniformization of the results, to be sure that we have the maximum in-brace correction. But it's also possible to I think, with many patients under shoulder brace. Also in the States, we have, I think, 20 students in the certification for the Lion Brace, and they show me the results of patients under shoulder brace. And sometimes we have excellent results, but they don't use the total time. So they lose the plastic deformation, the creep of the concavity. And this is a key point for the adult evolution after the removal of the brace.
After weaning the brace, yeah. That's the only way you're going to get
yes.
slowing progression, which when you make plastic deformation, because that's permanent, right?
You have a real modification of the length of the... Alors, we work on the fascia. There are a lot of the fascia tissue of the back, but not only. You know that at the muscle level, you have the actin, myosin. This is for the motion, the movement, but also the titin. The titin is the stiffness. It's an elastic component of the muscle. And the different rigidity, stiffness of the patient are due to a genetic modification of this titin, of this stiffness. So also at the muscle level, we can have a modification of the working modification of the movement of the motion of the muscle, yes.
Dr. Demore, I think we'll end today's session on the Lion method of physiotherapy, specific scoliosis exercises. Thank you so much for presenting the history and the evolution of the Lion method. I really appreciate how you look at the posture and the evolution of posture as a child grows over time, and how that's linked to the mechanical correction of the Lion method as well. Thank you so much, sir. And we'll talk soon.
Thank you.